Hulk! What's up? What are you doing?
What do you mean, what's up, Mean Gene? I'm getting ready for that no-good, low-life rattlesnake, Terry Funkman.
This is how you prepare for a title defense?
You better believe it, Mean Gene. This is my high-test gasoline. This is the Hulkster's patented Python protein drink. And don't you dare give Terry Funk the recipe, man.
I won't.
Give it a good shot. That'll get you real pumped up, Mean Gene. Pretty good, huh?
Whoa.
Oh, yeah, Mean Gene. No.
Formula?
A little more biceps, a little more tries. You better try some more of this. Look at that. Moby Dick with feet, right there.
What's that, Hot Rod?
Them fat hillbillies are taking a yearly bath and getting sunburned.
I thought I smelled bacon frying.
You know, there's only one thing that's worrying me.
Worry? What's to worry about?
After tonight, Humpy the Humpback Whale's gonna be out of the job.
Summit. Yes, the match that will see Corporal Kirstner square off against Nikolai Volkov in the allegedly scientific matchup, the Peace Match. And then from there, the Junkyard Dog teams up with Ricky the Dragon Steamboat in the tag team matchup to square off against Mr. Fuji and the Magnificent Morocco. This is just one of the challenges the Dog will face. The other will be a challenge, a 55-foot-high water slide competition with the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. Notwithstanding that, yes, the Animal back with us, George the Animal Steel, to square off against the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and of course, everyone waiting for the participants in the main event, the World Wrestling Federation up for grabs, the champion Hulk Hogan, meeting the number one contender, Terry Funk, and there is one other match, as a matter of fact, I almost forgot.
Wait a minute, McMahon, I'll tell you about the other match. Everybody saw on the last Saturday night main event how these hillbilly hits double-teamed and attacked Jesse the Body. You know who I'm talking about, Hillbilly Jim, Uncle Elmer, and Cousin Mud Pie, or whatever his name is. Well, I'm teaming up with Hot Rod, Rowdy Roddy Piper, Cowboy Bob Orton, and Jesse the Body in the ring.
I was going to tell everybody about that.
Wait a minute. You don't understand the significance of this, McMahon. I'm the first announcer in history that is going to step into the ring and back up what I say. Do you think you ever see Brent Musburger put on a pair of cleats, go nose to nose and toes to toes with Refrigerator Perry? The refrigerator would eat that Musburger up. You think you'd ever see Vin Scully standing there, look down the pipe and take a high hard one under the nose from Dwight Gooden? No way. But the Body is the only one who can back up his words and step into the ring.
I'm looking forward to you stepping in the ring for a different reason, because I don't have to listen to your lopsided commentary, Mr. Ventura.
Wait just a minute, McMahon. If you think I'm stepping into the ring and allowing you to sit here and talk yourself, you're badly mistaken. I went out and got the only man with brains enough to replace the Body. That is Bobby the Brain Heenan. Come on in here, Bobby. Fine job. I gotta get together with my partners.
Well, Mr. Heenan, welcome to the hot seat.
Well, it's a pleasure to be here, Vince McMahon. I just hope I can live up to the high excellence of broadcasting that Jesse Ventura has exampled out here.
The high excellence of broadcasting.
That is correct.
Well, speaking of that, let's take this now to Mean Gene Okerlund. Take it, Gene.
All right, I thank you very much, Vince McMahon, and good luck to you, Bobby Heenan. All right, Rowdy Roddy Piper, H. Cowboy and Bob Orton, along with your partner going up against Uncle Elmer, of course, one of the cousins in Hillbilly Jim.
Whoa, graffiti. What am I supposed to say, right?
Well, it's a vendetta.
You're talking about vendetta? Speak English. You're talking about people. Their idea of a good time is eating the feet of pigs. Then they go around and they play each other the banjo. I mean, America, how would you like to have Uncle Elmer for your uncle? Have you ever thought of that? You know what they got themselves into? Right here, this ain't the refrigerator man you're looking at. You're looking at deep freeze when it comes to Uncle Elmer and all these people. It wasn't me that jumped one-on-one on Jesse Ventura. It wasn't me that jumped two-on-one on Jesse Ventura. It wasn't me that did any of that. These jerks are the ones that asked for it. These pieces of garbage are the ones that asked for it. And aren't we going to give it to them?
Oh, that's right. Hey, Roddy, don't let this little cue ball bother you.
All
let
right.
Let me say it. See, wait a minute. The hillbillies, they're going down. They're going to be bad news in a dream after tonight.
I give up. Back to you, Vince McMahon.
Well, this is going to be some six-man tag team matchup, but it's certainly much more than just a match because the Hillbillies feel they have to avenge the actions of Piper and Ventura during Uncle Elmer's recent wedding. More specifically, Piper's interruptions of the solemn occasion and Ventura's scandalous remarks about Elmer's first marital kiss. Let's take you to a flashback.
It looks like two carp in the Mississippi River going after the same piece of corn.
All right, gentlemen, your opponents are in the ring. There's bad feelings, no doubt about it. And I'd like your thoughts. Hillbilly Jim.
Mean Gene, we're professional athletes. We're going to behave like professional athletes. No matter what them three polecats do up there. Our family honor's on the line right here. We're going to do what we got to do to win this match, no matter what.
All right, it's going to be Cousin Luke, Uncle Elmer, Hillbilly Jim going against Rowdy Roddy Piper and company. Back to you, Vince McMahon.
Country boy, don't mess with a country boy. When I was a little bitty boy, baby, I cut my teeth on a big old tree. Mama threw my brother from a moonshine field. My first meal was the best he killed.
All right, making his way to the ring. There he is, Hillbilly Jim. Good old Uncle Elmer, Cousin Luke, and I'll tell you, this is going to be one six-man tag team matchup. Bobby the Brain Heenan, you can bet the tippers are going to clear in this one.
You know, in my opinion, I think they ought to make them wear trunks and shoes like everybody else. They shouldn't be allowed to wrestle in those dirty Levi's.
Well, whether they're dirty or not, I'm not too sure, but you can bet, as was outlined earlier, this is family honor here.
Family honor, yeah.
That puts at stake.
Big family honor.
It's certainly more than just a wrestling match. The individuals that you have to look out for in terms of not adhering to the rules, the Jesse Ventura and company. And look at this. Oh, my. Jesse's going to catch a big one here. A real big one.
I doubt it.
Here we go.
Yeah, Jesse caught a big one, didn't he?
Ventura wrecking the face, a hard right hand. And another one.
And Uncle Elmer is really
being hammered by Jesse, the Bobby Ventura.
I'm sure
oh, look at that, however. Oh, man. Ventura down on one knee, doesn't know where he's pocket the crowd. I'm going to go out for another right hand. Ventura in bad shape now. Oh, look at that.
See, that's an illegal choke. He should be disqualified for that.
All right, what's going to happen now? Ventura with one in the Hillbilly Jim. Kind of say, here comes Hillbilly Jim. Over the top rope, Ventura in bad shape. He's eating his words right now.
The man never held on for the tag rope. It was an illegal tag as far as I'm concerned. Jesse was right about you. You're very biased. You're one-sided. You're against Ventura. You're against Piper and Orton and everybody else.
Nonetheless, a side headlock now applied by Hillbilly Jim. Whip to the ropes coming off. Shoulder play. Oh, no. He was up to the midsection. Cleverly done. Ventura able to tag out now. Rowdy Piper hammering away on Hillbilly Jim.
Ooh.
Whipped him with another right.
Cousin Luke now. Tagged in.
Luke.
And all of a sudden, Piper wants to check. I don't think so. No, I don't think so.
Come on, dummy. Shake hands. Pretend you're back home on the farm. Come on. You just sold another.
I don't believe Luke is that naive.
Oh, how about that? How about that? Luke hammering away. Look at this. Toe to toe.
You see, Piper's trying to do something nice, trying to extend his hand in friendship. And dumb hillbilly took advantage of it. That's not fair. That's not fair at all.
I'll
I'll tell you what's not fair is the cast on the arm of Cowboy Bob Orton. That's not fair.
He has an injury, McMahon. It's a proven injury. He's had a doctor. He's had letters. The arm has been broken.
It's the slowest healing injury, I think, of all time in the World Wrestling Federation. Look at this now. Piper with a shot right up under the throat.
Oh, big knee by Roddy Piper. Ooh.
Roddy Piper in rare.
Oh, wow. That's intimidation. That's the way he operates. That's why he's a winner.
With Cousin Luke. Luke now over in a not-so-friendly corner as Cowboy Bob Orton back wide open. Luke trying to find his way back to his corner. It puts his way out of there.
See, he made a mistake. He should have gone back to the corner. He was in trouble, but he stood there. Well, he's too dumb to get back to the corner.
Ventura back in. He's had some time to collect himself now. And the body. Boom. Ah.
I love it.
Ventura over to make the tag. Roddy Piper stepping through wide open. Cousin Luke. Piper takes his time. Look at his slap in the face. What humiliation. Oh. Piper. Resorting to his usual tactics. Tag made. Look at the frequent tag on the part of Roddy Piper's team. Ace from the top. Oh.
Wouldn't you agree with me that the team of Piper, Orton, and Ventura has completely outclassed these Hicks?
Outclassed?
Well, they've kept the ring cut. They've kept the man on their side. They've had him in the corner the whole time. Hillbillies haven't been able to generate any kind of an offense yet.
Luke now makes the tag. Here comes Hillbilly Jim. Jim in there with Piper.
No tag.
Oh, come on, Rob.
There ain't. There was no tag. There was no tag made.
Hawk. Piper. Ventura. And Orton certainly distracting the referee, doing an excellent job of it. Tag is made, Piper right back in there, and Cousin Luke is having his problems.
Now, yes, sir! To go Uncle Elmer against Roddy Piper. Piper locks up with Elmer. They're having a go on it here. Look at that. What a slugfest, Rick. On the eyes, Elmer now with a... Ooh.
That's all illegal. That's all illegal. Those are punches.
Elmer does. Yeah, that'll do it. Submission right there. Piper's going to bite the dust. Uncle Elmer.
Oh, no.
Look at that. Everybody's in the ring. The referee has lost complete control of this match.
It's out of control now. That's right, Jesse. Take off. If you're smart, Ronnie, you'll get out of there.
Yes, the Hillbillies are cleaning house in there.
Regroup. The best thing for them to do right now is to regroup.
All right, while they're regrouping, we'll be right back for the conclusion of this match. Stay tuned. Back of the Sun Dome, and the match is resuming. Here we go. We're taking up right where we left off.
See, the referee, I think, has completely lost control of this match now. The Hillbillies were the original ones that instigated this. They were the ones that started breaking the rules, and you know that as well as I do.
You must be looking at a different match than I am.
I'm sitting right next to you. I can see everything. Jesse warned me that you'd be like this. He warned me how you feel about him and how you're biased, one-sided.
Well, look at this. Talk about one-sided. Piper in there now. A series of headbutts setting up Hillbilly.
Oh!
That was one too many headbutt. Look at that. A right hand. Hillbilly Jim winds up. Roddy Piper tag is... No. Can't make the tag. Reaching for it.
Just inches away, and Piper's going to... He just slapped him. But look at Piper. What a paintbrush job.
Toe to toe. Wind up now. Hillbilly Jim with Piper in control.
Back him in that corner, Ronnie. There he goes. That's a smart ref.
Yeah, look at this. Double team. Soon it's going to be a triple team with Ventura in there.
Hey, you fight fire with fire. The Hillbilly started it. They're just going to finish it.
Ventura with a forearm.
I don't like it when them Hillbillies are on their knees. That's when they look the best to me.
Elbow to the back of Hillbilly Jim. Roddy Piper through the ropes out. Piper. No, missing with a right shot. Hillbilly Jim tags out. Here comes Cousin Luke.
I don't know how you can tell them apart. All those Hillbillies look alike to me.
Cousin Luke hammering away on Roddy. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Oh, Bob, this Luke is stepping up.
Piper gets behind him.
He's got a submission hold.
That's a sleeper on him.
Drop kick.
All right.
A
I think the referee... No, Luke trying to find a play out of that.
Come on, referee, get them hillbillies out of there. Get them hillbillies out of there.
The hillbillies really picking up on him. All right. Who did you see that?
Oh, he must have tripped. He lost his footing.
Look at this. Ace Orton now readjusting the cast. Ace Orton, we saw blatantly, hit Cousin Luke right behind the head. Oh, yeah, the sleeper is on Luke, all right, and he's out, but not because of the sleeper. It's because of Ace using that illegal cat. Trip lost his footing.
Experience, knowledge, and wrestling always pays off.
The winners of this match, the team of Cowboy Bob Orton, Jesse the Body Ventura, and Rowdy Piper.
You talk about birds of a feather. Ventura wins a cheap victory, and you, Bobby, allege Cousin Luke tripped.
Let me ask you, you think you maintained a standard of excellence you made reference to earlier?
Well, I just hope I did my job in commentating as good as Jesse did in the ring. Congratulations, Jesse.
Thank you, Bobby Heenan. It was my pleasure. I thought I was just outstanding in the ring, and I know, Bobby, that you were no less than perfect right here on the microphone.
Well, is there any future for you two, maybe in a tag team combination or something like that?
Well, I'll tell you what you better watch out for, McMahon. I'm sure Bobby Heenan did so good. You better watch out. You might end up in the unemployment line. I'd love to see you, McMahon, humble you down about 6 months in unemployment. Ha!
All right, let's go to Mean Gene Okerlund now for more fun in the sun.
Welcome, everyone, to Adventure Island, Tampa, Florida, a beautiful park featuring all the thrills one could have on water. You'll be seeing more of the park later on, but first, we have a water slide competition that will make your hair stand on end. A little background first. On our last Saturday night's main event, we all saw the Junkyard Dog, DePants, and brand manager Jimmy Hart. Well, Jimmy wants revenge, and since these men could not fairly meet in the ring, Hart has challenged Junkyard Dog to this contest. Now, Jimmy, what do you hope to prove with this challenge?
Gene, this is a matter of pride to me. The Junkyard Dog on national TV humiliated me unfairly. You saw it, everybody saw it. Now, I can't out-wrestle the Junkyard Dog, but, hey, there's one contest I know I can beat him at. And the Junkyard Dog's agreed to this contest. And when it's over with, I'm going to prove to everybody that I'm a better man than the Junkyard Dog.
Well, I don't know about that, but I do know, Junkyard Dog, you had one requirement.
Well, me and Gene, you know how those cute little onions that Hart wore on top of his line of Brandon with? I'd had one stipulation, baby. If you wear those red onions out here, those cute little red onions, then I agree to do this. So, me and Gene, let's get this thing going.
Let's get going. Let's open up the floodgate.
Wait just a minute. Something happened up there. Jimmy Hart got a slow start. The Junkyard Dog, he's got an advantage. He's used to being on his back. Something was not kosher up there. Jesse the Body did not like that start. I think Jimmy Hart got a raw deal. Something is not right here. I'm going to find out. Well, I think Jimmy Hart had a friction problem wearing this shoe. And whoever was running that gate up there gave the Junkyard Dog a 2-second head start. Well, Terry, you don't really look like the beach type to me. What are you doing here?
Tonight, after I beat the heavyweight champion Hulk Hogan, all the national press will be taking my picture, and I want a great tan for the cover of Sports Illustrated.
Well, I don't know if Sports Illustrated's here, Terry.
They better be. They put that overrated blonde blowhard Hogan on the cover. They better put me on it when I'm through, or I'll fry them, both of them. I'll fry them with my iron. That's a promise. Do you understand, Ventura?
Yes. Well, Sports Illustrated, you've been warned. And if you don't believe me, take a look at this report from Gorilla Monsoon.
Thank you, Jesse. Gorilla Monsoon here with a special update from the Mile High City, Denver, Colorado. Championship match title on the line. The Hulkster against Terrible Terry Funk got things going pretty good his way right now. Drops the big leg on him, going for the three count, but look at that. The Mouth of the South up on the apron, distracts the champion. Look at that branding iron, that ominous piece of garbage dropped into the ring by the Mouth of the South. Now Funk's got it, wow, right between the eyes. The champion drops out onto the apron. Terry Funk, a very devious individual, along with his manager. And look at the count going out. The Hulk is laying on the apron. There's a bystander from the outside passing the belt into the ring a little prematurely, I think. Now the champion dragged back into the middle, but the bell is already rung here. And now, embarrassment and humiliation for champion Hulk Hogan as that branding iron just ripped right into his pectoral muscles. This match is over right now. You can go to the bank with that. Here's the guys that think they are the new champions. Unbelievable event. Champion can only change hands on a pinfall or submission. They were the winners of the match. I wouldn't want to be in their shoes when they meet the Hulk again.
All right, thank you, Gorilla Monsoon, for that report. Hulk Hogan, now we've all seen what Terry Funk perpetrated on you in Denver, Colorado. Any special plans for revenge?
Yeah, there sure is, Mean Gene. You know, that Terry Funk busted me up with that Brandon iron. Then he humiliated me and all of Denver, and he branded me with that double cross. And just to make sure that doesn't happen tonight on Saturday night's main event, I got a special surprise for you, you know. If you can dig it, man, the Junkyard Dog is going to be in my corner to make sure that nothing like that happens. All right, JYD.
Junkyard Dog.
I got a lot in plan for these boys. Hulk Hogan will do his thing, and I'm going to see our dog, and I can see real well.
Bet you're going to be keeping an eye on Jimmy Mouth of the South Park.
I'm going to keep an eye on Jimmy real close. I'm going to be closer to Jimmy than his Beaver D's.
All right, Junkyard Dog and heavyweight champ Hulk Hogan, gentlemen. Don't let me hold you up. I thank you
very
much.
Every dog needs the bone that you want, and Terry Funk is mine, brother.
All right. Vince, I've got a feeling that something special is going to be coming down tonight. I can't wait.
There's no doubt it's something special. Hulk Hogan hits his way through this capacity crowd on his way to the square circle. And what I believe, Jesse Ventura, is the most important match for Hulk Hogan since WrestleMania.
Well, I'll tell you, McMahon, I'll agree to that simply by the fact that why is he bringing the Junkyard Dog down the ringside with him? Is the man afraid? Is he scared of little 120-pound Jimmy Hart?
Jimmy Hart being ushered to his seat by the Junkyard Dog.
That is ridiculous right there. Look at the Junkyard Dog. Isn't he tough pushing around little Jimmy Hart?
Hopefully we will not have a repeat of Denver. You saw the Denver footage. Hulk Hogan, no doubt, looking forward to this title defense against Terry Funk. No doubt the most important match.
Saturday night, main event is back in the beautiful Sundome, and we're ready for our title matchup. Here we go. This is going to be a great one, Jess. Look at that. Lock it up now. The Hulks are back to the corner. Terry Funk brings him out. No reversal. No trouble with that. Look at this. Hulkster sends Funk for the rock. Falls right in.
To know what right the Junkyard Dog has being out here. He is not a legal manager. He's not a manager like Jimmy Hart. He has no business out here, McMahon.
Indeed he does. You saw the footage from Denver. There's every reason in the world for the Junkyard Dog to be watching the backside of Hulk Hogan. Terry Funk now. Back into the ring. Referee Deb Hittner putting the count on him and beating the count back in.
Funk is tough. Oh, he's tough. He likes to refer to himself as middle-aged and crazy.
He's more than that. Terry Funk, number one contender. Funk with a chop. Another one. Look at him. Terry Funk winds it.
Oh, again, reversal. To the rock.
Look at the Junkyard Dog, the tough guy he is, chasing little 110-pound Jimmy Hart back to his chair when all Jimmy wanted to do was come and check on Terry Funk's status of injury outside the ring.
Terry Funk giving credit after that tremendous blow. Back up now on the apron, making his way back in. He is a competitor all the way around. Funk, a man able to mix it up in almost any fashion. He has the scientific knowledge. He can roughhouse it with the best of them as well. Walking back up the Hulkster now. In control of things. Terry Funk whips him to the rope for the ride. Goes downstairs. Oh, look at that. Hulkster's coming right over. Look at this. Back and forth. Back and forth. And finally hooking the rope and outside Terry Funk.
Junkyard Dog being here.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
The Junkyard Dog can set the game plan of the Mouth of the South with Terry Funk. They're going to have to stay outside for a while, regroup, and start all over again, McMahon, in my opinion.
Terry Funk on the apron, making his way right back in before being counted out. What a matchup so far.
Come on, Terry, you can take it, baby. You can take it.
Terry Funk circling, trying to collect his thoughts now.
Jimmy Hart getting that megaphone going outside the ring. I can hear it.
Oh, he is the mouth of the South. Maybe of the North, East, and West as well. Hulkster now back to the corner. Funk with a southpaw chop. Another one. Hulkster whips it back around.
Right there.
Look, what a suplex. Go for the cover. He's not going for the pin. Yes, he does. He's a little late. All he can get is two. Hulkster hesitating just a bit. I think he was distracted by Jimmy Hart.
He definitely hesitated. It cost him.
Headbutt by Funk. Funk with another one. Terry Funk building a little momentum now. Side hit. Oh. Funk with a kick. I think he was trying to get the shins. Of Hulk Hogan. We'll call that an accident. Funk kicking away now. Oh, going out to the apron
now.
Terry Funk on his way to the top rope. Look at this. Oh, talk about poetic justice. Hulk Hogan with Terry Funk knee to the spine. Oh, baby.
Funk is in trouble right here. He made a mistake, and Hogan's capitalizing on it.
Headbutt by Hogan. Hogan trying to set up Funk. Puts him to the rope. What a clothesline. Drops the elbow. Yes, sir. Go for it. Hulk Hogan with momentum. Hulk Hogan with all kinds of momentum. The champion now with a side headlock on Terry Funk, the challenger. What a matchup. To the rope and off. No. Oh, you saw that. You saw that, Jesse. At low life, Jimmy Hart.
Oh, yeah.
Now, he can't go that way. He can't go anyway. Jimmy Hart underneath the ring.
Get him out. You blame him. He weighs 120 pounds.
It better hide. Meanwhile, Terry Funk, I believe, has something in his hand. Is choking him, I think. Yes. Terry Funk has some tape from around his wrist, and he's choking and choking the champion. Jimmy Hart, back on the mega.
Look at how brilliant Funk is. He has that forearm in front. Referee Dave Hefner, totally blinded, does not even know the tape is there. I love it. What a genius Funk is.
You can call it genius, I suppose.
What a ring genius Terry Funk is.
Funk now, quickly throwing the tape away, risking being disqualified, and the referee seen it.
He already did the damage.
Yes, he has done the damage indeed. Hulk Hogan is in bad shape now. Terry Funk, uh-oh. Here comes a pile driver. That's going to be it. We're going to have a new champion crowned. Hulk Hogan, pile drive.
This could
Terry
be it,
Funk.
McMahon.
It is. We have one. We have a count of two. We have a count of three.
Oh, that referee was slow. Referee was slow. He was slow, McMahon. Come on, admit it.
I'm not too sure about that.
He was slow. He hesitated.
Boy, was that ever close. That's the closest I've ever seen. Hulk Hogan coming to being pinned, and Terry Funk is now really going to take advantage. Look at that. However, the Junkyard Dog encouraging Hulk Hogan. This capacity crowd here in beautiful Florida encouraging Hulk Hogan. I think it's working. Can't you feel it?
Feel that pushing. Hit him, Funk, hit him.
Look at Hulk Hogan coming along. Funk with a series of jabs. They seem to have no effect. Roundhouse right by the Hulkster. Another. Hulk with Terry Funk. To the ropes and off. Oh, what an elbow. No, won't let him go down. Terry Funk being set up by the champion off the rope. The big boot. Uh-oh. All right, now Jimmy Hart's on the apron. And look, Jesse, in his right hand, the branding iron.
What do you expect, McMahon? Jimmy Hart always carries the branding iron. That's nothing new.
Hulk's setting up Terry Foote. Jimmy Hart on the apron again. Oh, he nails Hogan. Oh, no, don't cover him. Don't beat him this way, too. The foot on the bottom rope saves Hulk Hogan.
Oh, I can't believe the referee saved him. Whoa, look at that. The Junkyard Dog has just assaulted Jimmy Hart outside the ring, McMahon. What do you have to say to that?
Oh, no doubt he deserved it, that's for sure. Hulk Hogan. Now Terry Fox spins around. Oh, look at that. What a clothesline. Hooks the leg. One, two, count of three.
What a cheap shot on the part of Champion Hogan. Terry Funk over discussing the problem with the referee. Hogan sitting back, waiting for his opportunity, coming in with a cheap shot and saving his title. I can't believe it, McMahon.
Oh, look at this. Oh, no. Terry Funk out there now with the referee. Look what he's doing. I suppose you're going to tell me that's justified, too.
It is after what that referee did to Terry Funk. I don't blame Terry Funk.
The WWF will take action against Terry Funk for what we just saw. Hulk Hogan reaches down for him. A disgruntled Terry Funk, who has lost his opportunity to win the World Wrestling Federation. Look at this.
That's Texas sportsmanship right there. Hook 'em horns. I love it.
All right, here comes the announcement. Hulk Hogan! All right, yes, sir. Hulk Hogan and a successful title defense. A real American, if there ever was.
You call that successful, McMahon? He's got the JYD assaulting poor Jimmy Hart, lying on the outside of the ring after what the JYD did to him. I don't call that success.
All right, well, stay tuned, everybody.
The Junkyard Dog assaulting Jimmy Hart outside the ring. Terry Funk never saw a foot on the rope, and he's discussing it with the referee right now, and Hogan sitting back waiting for his opportunity.
Look at this, and boy, an opportunity knock. Answering the door of opportunity, Hulk Hogan. What a tremendous victory. Let's take you now to Mean Gene Okerlund.
All right, thank you very much, Vince McMahon. I cannot believe it. I knew we were going to have action. Hulk Hogan, I did not anticipate this.
You know, Terry Funk, why don't you drag off that dead manager of yours, you know? But you know what, boy? I had enough. Come on back, Funk. Come on
back. All right. Hulk Hogan, Junkyard Dog, come on in. JYD, you did a nice job of keeping an eye on the Jimmy Mouth of the South Park.
They don't call me Devin the Dog for nothing.
All right, Vince, let's go back to you.
Well, Jimmy Hart's on his way out of the wrestling scene, but George the Animal Steele is on his way back in. And I'll tell you, once you've seen the Animal, you never forget him. As evidenced here by his first appearance on Saturday night's main event, where he became a little disoriented. He sought treatment from the famed psychiatrist, gynecologist, Dr. Sigmund Zip.
Believe it was working.
Intelligent. Say something intelligent now, George.
How now, Brown Cow?
Hey, Doc!
Treatment
ultimately failed, but Mean Gene Okerlund tracked down the animal at, of all places, the Detroit Zoo.
Why, you quack, you!
George, I'm glad to see that you're feeling good, and we look forward to seeing you back in the ring.
Bye.
Goodbye, George. Goodbye.
And so finally, George, the animal, Steele has returned to the wrestling scene, and Mean Gene Okerlund is with him.
Oh, Captain Lou Albano, George the Animal Steele looks very relaxed after his layoff. You think he's suffering from ring rust?
You mean because of his water?
No, Lou, ring rust is what happens when you haven't wrestled in a long time. Is he going to be 100% tonight?
100%? 100% of capacity. He'll be 100% mentally and physically.
All right, Lou, best of luck to you and George. Right now, let's find out from Jesse Ventura if the Macho Man has taught the lovely Elizabeth how to swim.
Ducky?
Please.
This is what we're gonna do.
Hey, are you two planning tonight's strategy?
For who, man?
For your opponent, George the Animal Steele.
Why should I be worried about him?
Well, you've never wrestled him, and George, he's a little bit different.
Jesse, what do they call me?
Macho Man.
What do they call George?
The Animal.
Jesse, would a real man be scared of an animal? My main purpose here today is to teach this woman how to swim.
Hey, aren't you gonna give her a couple lessons?
Sure I am. This is lesson number one.
What are you laughing? How dare you listen to something like that?
I'll tell you what I'm laughing about, McMahon. Can you imagine what it's going to be like when the Macho Man teaches Elizabeth how to parachute?
She could have drowned. Were you going to dive in and save Elizabeth?
Hey, she didn't drown. Take a look over Randy's shoulder. There's Elizabeth. She learned how to swim. If you ask me, it was a pretty good lesson.
Well, that's really treating your manager with a lot of respect, isn't it?
Well, I'll tell you what, the Macho Man, he knows how to treat Elizabeth. Look at there, he's sending her up to the ring, sending her up to do his job, and I believe he's been distracted by the crowd. Somebody wants to look at his beautiful body.
Elizabeth, holding up. Wait a minute, what's this? Yes, as you said. Oh, but look at this. The animal coming over next to Elizabeth. Now there's someone who appreciates Elizabeth.
Oh, that makes me sick, McMahon.
Sick?
Did you look at that? The animal steal, he's rubbing his head, he's pawing Elizabeth. How come she's sitting there taking that kind of stuff?
It looks kind of like King Kong and Jessica Lange, don't you think?
King Kong, here comes Lou Albano. That's it, Albano, you're manager of the year. Push that moron back to his corner where he belongs. Do your job, Albano.
Hey, did you see the look in the eye of the... Well, now we see the look in the eye of the Macho Man. He's hot. Why?
I can't blame him. Elizabeth should have jumped away from that animal steal instead of sitting there letting him paw her.
Tell you, the animal would certainly treat Elizabeth with a lot more respect than the Macho Man does. Look at it.
Macho Man's putting her in her place, telling her what's happening right here.
Well, George the Animal Steel, seeing Elizabeth for the first time, and boy, is he ever smitten. I hope he can keep his mind on the matchup.
Yeah, speaking of minds, McMahon, take a look at that. There's a melding of the minds. Mr. Spock could be proud to see those two, Albano and Steel.
And Elizabeth now doing her duties as the manager of the Macho Man.
Yeah, and the Macho Man putting her in her place. Tell her what it's like, Randy. Put her in her place. Make her do her job.
I don't think the animal would treat her that way.
Randy, Macho Man, Savage, giving the stuff. There it is. Tell her, Randy. Tell her not to be messing with that animal. Make her sit down and take care of your stuff.
All right, the match just about underway. The Macho Man and the animal, the most unorthodox wrestler in the world today, bar none. The Macho Man is going to have his, look at this, look at this. And the Macho Man quickly outside.
Well, that's a smart move in my opinion, McMahon. He wasn't quite ready. He'll take his time, get regrouped, and get back in there.
Look at the agility of the Macho Man. Over the top rope moments ago now. Look. And again, look at the animal. Going after the Macho Man, and the Macho Man is confused.
I wouldn't say he's confused. I might run, too. Look how ugly the animal is.
On the top rope, the Macho Man, the animal wisely backing off a bit. Now locking up. Back to the rope, and the animal appears to be salivating.
Over the top rope!
That's the way the animal treats the Macho on the outside. Here comes the animal. He's looking at Elizabeth, the Macho Man. Now the animal coming back to his senses just in the nick of time. Again, distracted there by Elizabeth.
Well, I don't know how you can say distracted. Elizabeth's just standing there. You know, hey, it's obvious, McMahon. The animal steal is one or two cards short of a deck of 52.
I won't argue with you there, Jeff. The animal on the outside. And you better watch because, yes, we've seen the Macho Man leap from the top rope to the concrete floor. Over the animal, party coming in underneath the rope. Macho Man, Randy Savage with a knee lift now, trying to wear down the furry animal. George Steele, with a right hand. And another. The animal kicking. The left foot now, and another one. Uh-oh. Macho Man, with George the Animal still outside, hammering away. Elbows in the back of the head. Well, Macho Man is a tough one. The animal gives it right back to him in the midsection. One round and round now. Savage running from Georgia. Oh, he pulled it. I can't believe he was stooped so low.
What a brilliant maneuver. Look at Steele trying to manhandle Elizabeth.
He was not trying to manhandle her at all. I think he was trying to... And again, Steele was distracted by Elizabeth. Yes, buckle after buckle. For some reason, he has some sort of fetish or something in the corner. But from behind, the Macho Man.
Now that should be a disqualification, McMahon. You got to figure that turnbuckle's like a foreign object out there, the way that George the Animal Steel's using it.
Well, the animal, we said earlier on, very fond of the stuffings in the corner pad. And now look, but he's looking at Elizabeth again. Look. He is smitten. The animal, I think, is really He may even be taken.
Oh, the top rope! What a quick cover!
He got it! Can't believe it!
Oh, no! What's the Macho Man doing? He has Elizabeth on his shoulder as Elizabeth looks back at the animal! And in the ring, it's Lewis Howe battle the captain with George the Animal Steel, and he was distracted to the extent that there would have cost him the match. The Animal loses the match, but I think one thing happened to him tonight, Chess. I think he fell in love.
You really think so, McMahon?
What did he just say?
I thought I heard him say something.
He belched, I think.
That wasn't a belch.
Well, the Animal thinks he won. The only thing I'll tell you, we do have a winner coming up for you now, the 1985 Year in Review.
Yeah, I know that song. I really like that. Mean Gene. Hey, Gino.
Oh, you got a boogie on down, Hulkster.
What are you doing, Mean Gene?
What do you mean, what am I doing? Listening to a song we made a video for.
A video of what?
The highlights of the World Wrestling Federation in 1985.
Like WrestleMania?
You'd better believe it.
Well, let's watch it.
You heard the Hulkster. Let's roll it.
When the going gets tough, the tough get going, 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 going.
Wrestling Federation Year in Review video.
Wait, just a minute, McMahon. Did I blink or did I miss Jesse the Body Ventura?
Well, that's right. You weren't in it, were you?
I'll tell you what. I know who's to blame. Probably you and that so-called executive producer, that spindly leg, knobby knee Dick Ebersole, who thinks he created Saturday Night Live.
As far as I'm concerned, he's always had good taste, Jesse.
Taste? Like what, Charlie Tuna?
Well, take it, Gene.
With me at this time, manager Fred Blassie and the Big Russian from Moscow. He is Nikolai Volkov tonight. a peace match with Corporal Kirshner.
That's right, Mean Gene. We Russians are peaceful people who will not stop till we bring the peace to the whole world. This match tonight is the first step to end American militarism by a superior wrestling through the Russian Socialist Republic and much more superior.
All right, I thank you very much. Oh, Iron Chief, what are you doing here?
Jimmy Russia, number one. Iran, number one.
That's right, Chief. Tonight, everyone will see America is just a paper tiger.
But I'll tell you what, Fred Blassie, this is not going to be a tag team bout. This man is not an authorized manager. He's not going to be in the ring.
Listen, Okerlund, he's here to lend his moral support. He's a good friend of both of us.
Gentlemen,
trying to make a big issue.
I'm sorry we're out of time. Right now, we're going to go to Jesse the Body Ventura, who spoke with Purple Kirshner earlier on.
So on land and in the air, Corporal Kirshner has shown his stuff. Can he do the same in water? We'll have to see. Corporal Kirshner, you seem at home anywhere. Why is that?
Because the United States military has given me the finest training and survival that's very possible. Anywhere I'm dropped in this world, ice, land, snow, I don't care where it is. I'm going to survive. I'm going to prevail.
So, because of your training, you feel you'll best Nikolai Volkov. But remember, Corporal, this is a peace match. Combat techniques will not be allowed.
Going up against a Russian strongman. I'm not going to need combat tactics. We're going into this as a professional wrestling match, and the best man is going to win. But I'm going to go in there on a search and destroy mission, and I'm coming out ahead.
Cool off, Corporal Kirshner. That match is later. Right now, why don't you show the viewers the proper method of entering the water?
Stand back, Jesse, and let me show you how it's done.
Request that you all please rise and respect his singing of the Soviet National Anthem.
Gorbachev earlier on national TV this week, so only right we're going to have right here the peace match, Corporal Kirshner squaring off against Nikolai Volkov.
And along with Jesse Ventura back in Tampa, Florida, and we are ready for the matchup. Corporal Kirshner now against Nikolai Volkov. Volkov with much more experience. Kirshner has not been in the WWF all that long. Clean break by Nikolai Volkov. That's the way he said it was going to be. Really to prove his scientific skills as compared to those and contrasted to those of course, Corporal Kirshner.
I think we're also going to have to see, McMahon, who is the most honest here. We got to see if honesty prevails in this bout.
Honesty?
Honesty, if they both keep it scientific.
Well, Kirshner is a real rugged individual. And with his military background, it'll be interesting to see just how well he can... All right, Nikolai Volkov, tight waist, nice maneuver. Nice takedown by Volkov. Front hook the elbow, nice roll. Nice maneuver there into the armbar. Kirshner in control. Volkov trying to make his way back to his feet now. Kirshner standing side headlock. Grinds it out on the big rush and takes him over to him. Nicely done, Jesse.
Very nicely done, McMahon. Hey, I call it like it is.
Shoulders on the canvas. Two.
Now, if you'll notice, too, Nikolai Volkov did not pull any trunks on that either, McMahon.
I didn't see it. You're right.
No, he didn't.
Thus far, it's 50-50 right down the line. Volkov trying to power out. Kirshner should not test him here. Volkov so powerful.
This is Volkov's advantage. He's got about 40 or 50 pounds on Kirshner, and I believe he's definitely more stronger.
Sheikin. Freddy Blassie looking on, and I don't believe that the Iron Sheik has any reason at all to be at ringside. Look at this. Test of strength. I can't believe how strong Kirshner is.
I can't believe this. Where is he getting that from?
Kirshner holding his own with a powerful Russian Volkov.
rocking back and forth, top wrist lock. Referee right there, up against the rope.
Ah, we got to see on some honesty. Hey, we got it. I think
Volkov intentionally back to the rope there.
Intentionally.
Which is not to say it's an illegal maneuver. It's just to say that I think he was surprised at the strength of Kirshner.
Might well be, McMahon.
Put me behind, Volkov. Takes him down again. Rolls him up. Look at that.
Good. That was nice.
Well, thus far, Nikolai Volkov.
You know, McMahon, seeing a bridge like that, now I know why there's not much hair on the top of Nikolai's head.
That may be one reason. From behind, nice maneuver. Kirshner hooks the head, throws him up. It's going to be a pivot.
No,
only one. Quite a maneuver on the part of Volkov, who takes the momentum right on over. Standing side headlock once again. Kirshner trying to grind it out of it.
So far, this piece match, we've had all clean breaks. I can't believe it, McMahon. Even I'm amazed. Look at another one.
There's another one. Yes, sir. Again, this, I believe, I've been told that it's a direct result of the handshake there.
Wow.
This is a good example of certainly what two countries, what two participants representing countries can do in athletic competition. Thus far, it's a great match. Chicken Blessing. Not exactly like looking for the ankle now. Volkov, nice maneuver. A kick by Corporal Kirshner. Scoops up a bit.
Oh, look at that.
Short block by Big Volkov. Went for the ropes again. Oh, Kirshner this time sends him to the rope. And up. Yes. Nice takedown. Volkov not expecting that at all. Kirshner sidestepping him.
Well, what Kirshner's doing here and on that last move, McMahon, he used Volkov's weight against himself on that. A good leverage move and now Chicken Wing into a hammer lock.
Trying to scoop it. Look at that. Ball back is out of doors. We have two. No. Wow. Powerful Nikolai Volkov kicking out of a small package. You don't often see that. Gets the rope now. Another clean. No. That was not a clean break. Off that one now. Volkov off the rope. Drops a knee. Scoots him up. Oh.
The ropes, I'll give you that.
He what?
He nailed him in the ropes when he should have broke clean.
That was just the start of it. Kirshner's hot. Kirshner is really hot. Kirshner on the Sheik as well. Hammering away. Scoops up the Sheik. Slams him down the canvas. Volkov hammered away. Look at this. Kirshner better watch himself. Double team going. Justifiably so. Volkov bending and indeed out, not breaking the rules. That was far from a peace match. Corporal Kirshner will be ready for Volkov in the future, no doubt of that, but standing by, certainly an individual who's really going to be ready. We make reference to one of the participants in the tag match to follow, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. You remember what happened with Fuji in Morocco?
That's right, Fuji in Morocco doing in the Dragon, and the Dragon has taken the Junkyard Dog as a partner. Well, I think the dog's bitten off more than he can chew. He ain't fighting no 110-pound manager now.
Well, 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 you still have a way with the ladies, but more importantly, Don Morocco and Mr. Fuji, you two have a history in your matches of using illegal tactics with Ricky Steamboat.
Oh, is little Ricky complaining?
No, 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 no. All I was going to say is Ricky Steamboat has as a partner tonight the Junkyard Dog, and I think that could possibly present a problem for the two of you.
If I was a mailman in red suspenders, then I'd be worried about the Junkyard Dog. But seeing as how... Mr. Fuji, what do you do with dogs in Japan?
Mr. Fuji?
In my country, we roast dogs, live dogs, boiled dogs, Junkyard Dogs, and have these points.
Let's go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, Vince, there you have it. two sportsmen showing no signs of changing their style. And tonight should be very interesting, especially considering that Ricky Steamboat has the Junkyard Dog as his partner. Vince McMahon, let's go back to you.
What about all this gobbledygook, Jesse, about boiled dog, fried dog, all that stuff?
Well, I'll tell you what, McMahon, in Japan, they even eat raw dog.
Raw dog? Maybe you never heard about hot dog before. Let's take you over now to Mean Gene again.
You know, I just don't know, Ricky Steamboat. You must be a glutton for punishment. You've been hijacked, hoodwinked, bushwhacked virtually everything by the likes of Mr. Fuji and the Magnificent Morocco.
You know something, Mean Gene? From Maine to California, from Canada all the way down here to Florida, you said I've been bushwhacked and all that. I've been hung and I've been blasted with a chair. I've been assaulted. I've had everything done to me. But there's one thing that those two guys have not done, and that is defeat me in the middle of that ring.
And by the way, I should point out, you've got quite a partner at your side tonight.
I've got the best man I could have in this particular night. He's got the biggest bite of all. But you know something? I think those two bit off a little bit more than they could chew. Ain't that right, dog?
Jay Whitey.
You know me and Gene. These guys, man, been doing everything they could to Ricky. Also, to a lot of people, they're sending a bad trend in the wrestling world. They're bringing away, sending some type of trend that want the kids to follow them. But me and Gene, I don't like it. I know you don't want your kids to follow, and I'm going to try my best to help Ricky to do something about it.
Cinch him up, gentlemen. I thank you very much, Ricky Steamboat, Junkyard Dog. Back to you, Vince.
All right, as we hear another one bites the dust, I wonder if that tune indeed is a bad omen for Mr. Fuji and the Magnificent Morocco.
Well, I'll tell you what, McMahon, it just seems that J.Y.D., he thinks he's Ajax, stronger than dirt, flying in like the White Knight to help his buddy Hogan. Now he figures he's going to come in and help Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. I'll tell you what, McMahon, I don't think so.
The Dragon, Ricky Steamboat, and the Junkyard Dog teaming up against Mr. Fuji, the Magnificent Morocco. The name of the game is continuity here. You're going to have that all-important teamwork.
That's right. Teamwork's the name of the game. Fuji and Morocco got it. I don't know if Steamboat and the Dog do.
All right, stay tuned for the tag team coming your way. Back with more Saturday Night's Main Event. Here we go. And right away, pandemonium breaks loose.
I'll tell you, Morocco and Fuji have taken advantage right here at the start, just like I called it, McMahon. They all know I'm the man who calls it the way it is.
All right, Fuji down on the outside, Morocco on the inside. Morocco taking care of the Junkyard Dog. And meanwhile, Mr. Oh, look at that. Oh, with a body slam on a concrete floor.
Wow, that'll definitely slow the old dragon down. You know, I'm like,
look at that knee left by Morocco.
Well, I think, McMahon, that the JYD may have bitten off more than he can chew with the Magnificent Morocco and the honorable one, Mr. Fuji.
Nice reversal. Morocco to the buckle. Comes out back. Body drop. Snap there. Over goes Morocco. The dog sets him.
No, misses. Whoa. The dog attempting to ram his head into probably the pectoral area of Morocco. Attack is made. Morocco gets a quick knee into the chest before attacking Mr. Fuji next time.
Well, he
shot by Fuji.
He definitely didn't have Morocco hurt bad enough to try something like that, and now Mr. Fuji's going to work with them karate techniques.
Look at the dog coming back. Scoop. Fuji's in the air. Slam to the canvas. Fuji backing off now. Look at this.
Hey, that's a smart move, McMahon. He's trying to fight for time.
And the clutches in the Junkyard Dog.
But now, Fuji, the martial art tactics are now right back in. Arm drag takedown, however. Morocco, right back in the clutches of the Junkyard Dog. Up he goes! Body slam to the canvas with authority. Cover referee out of position to get the two count. Morocco, didn't know where he was.
Yeah, you see, Morocco was stunned, walked into the wrong corner. You see, Steamboat, he took the cheap shot.
Why not?
Why not?
Yes, why not?
I thought he goes by the rules.
It's going to happen to Steamboat if the other side were reversed. If he were over there, it would definitely happen the other way around. The dog with a headbutt.
Whoa, right to the nose. Wow.
All right, Fuji back in now. Fuji had a lot of success earlier on. And again, going back to the martial arts practice. Look at that.
Fuji appears to have the dog's number here.
Did very well. Tag has made a frequent attack made by Fuji and Morocco. Wide open the dog. And big, magnificent Morocco in control. Drops the elbow. The dog would like nothing better right now than to tag his partner, Ricky Steamboat.
Well, Morocco and Fuji.
Oh, listen to this.
Magnificent's going in this match. match. Steamboat trying to get the dog up.
Morocco reaching over for the tag for Fuji. And indeed, here comes Mr. Fuji. The dog out trying to make a tag to the dragon. Cut off by Mr. Fuji. Must say, Fuji and Morocco doing a great job of cutting the dog off so far.
Oh, yeah, they've had about six or seven tags, and the dog's been in there since the start. Steamboat hasn't even broken a sweat on the apron.
Again, pretty good tag. Morocco back in the dog. The Jet Jar dog.
I wonder if the dog will be so anxious to help next time.
Reaching for the tag, Morocco cuts him off again. Morocco kicking, pretty much having his way at the moment with the Jet Jar dog. But this is one man you cannot count out until the match is completely over. The dog will claw, scratch, whatever it takes to get himself right back up. You knock him down, he's coming up. Steamboat is hot. The dog ripped to the buckle. Morocco sits. Oh, look at that!
Critical, critical mistake by the Magnificent One.
Well, the tag's going to be made. The Jet Jar dog coming over. And yes! Backing off Morocco. It looks like the dragon coming up.
Ooh!
On the top of it. Look at those chops. Morocco went to the buckle. Out and down the canvas. Fuji catches one. And another one. Morocco whipped to the ropes. Downstairs goes the dragon. Steamboat with a chop to the fourth. Look at that. Covering. Oh, covering. Here it comes. Setting him up now. Oh, it's a Fuji. That's a bad example of teamwork there. Ricky, the dragon Steamboat. Out on the apron. Going up to the top rope. What's he doing? Trying to set up Morocco. Fine body press. He'll get him. One, two.
Oh, no, he won't. Not with that sly Mr. Fuji in the corner. Always thinking, McMahon. Always thinking.
Fuji cuts off the dragon, Ricky Steamboat, who is trying to tag the dog. Look at that maneuver. Now the tag is made. Now the dog with a kick in the midsection. Headbutt by the dog. Cover by the Jet Jar dog. Two we make. Yes, we get three.
Oh, yeah.
What a matchup and what a tremendous victory. Go ahead, but by the dog.
I don't understand this, McMahon. Steamboat has won the match, and yet he's trying to carry it outside the ring with Morocco. Poor sport.
Oh, yeah, that's a nice cheap shot by Morocco. Another one. The match is over, and Morocco's trying to get his licks in any way he can.
Hey, Steamboat started it.
Well, I'll tell you, don't touch that now, because we're going to be back. More from Tampa, Florida, right after this. Stay tuned.
In the sun and Tampa, Florida. This has been sensational, Jesse.
That's right, McMahon. I'll tell you, it was a great night for Saturday Night Main Event.
No doubt we saw some very special things here tonight. I think perhaps there's no doubt the most special thing that we saw ever was the successful title defense of champion Hulk Hogan.
No, 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 no. The greatest thing we saw tonight, McMahon, was what Jesse the Body did. The first and only commentator to step into the ring. And I challenge any other commentator in the world to do what I have done and equal what I did.
Stay tuned. We'll be back with more Saturday Night's Main Event.
On behalf of all of us here on Saturday Night's Main Event, Jesse the Body Ventura, yours truly, Vince McMahon, we'd like to say so long until we see you on the next Saturday Night's Main Event. Happy New Year, everybody.